This truck carrying corn flour and pasta never made it to the grocery store. Looting in Venezuela is on the rise. That's made being a food delivery truck driver one of the worst jobs to have. Events like the ransacking of this truck are William Alojuela's worst nightmare.
You have to take more and more precautions. For example, you can't go to dangerous places. You have to go home earlier, and there are certain clients to whom you simply can't deliver anymore.
But William often has to drive through dangerous neighborhoods, like Petare in western Caracas, Venezuela's capital. He says he's already been kidnapped twice and can't even remember how many times he's been robbed.
Before, you ran the risk of common criminals wanting to steal your truck. But now you have to worry about the National Guard who want to extort you, or looters who want to take your load.
And it's only going to get worse. Scenes like this one have become the new normal. In June alone, there were on average 5 lootings or attempts at looting across the country every day. But that figure could be higher. This event we filmed was never reported.
People are sacking what they can, and they ransack a truck because they believe it has food and they want to satisfy their hunger. But they also feel they're exercising justice, because they feel that even if they have money, their salaries are no longer enough to buy food.
For the people waiting under the scorching sun in this queue, there is also the sense that things will never go back to how they were.
It's only getting worse. We are here because our cupboards are empty. We have been waiting here since 5 in the morning for just 2 small packages of flour, and then wait 8 days to be able to buy them again. Can you imagine how we feel?
The people in this crowd say, hungry, and above all, angry. Virginia Lopez, Al Jazeera, Caracas.